Let's discuss some example in which we have to evaluate the limits. Limit evaluations ki kuch zyada examples main nahi karunga because you have already done such type of examples during your courses of calculus. Calculus mein how to evaluate the limit. Ye aapne kafi examples jo hai wo discuss ki hongi. Lekin hum analysis ke course mein hamara emphasis jo hai wo zyada formal, mathematical, rigorous reasoning pe hai, proofs pe hai. That's why we are discussing more and more ke kis tarah kin techniques se jo theorems aapne calculus mein apply sirf kiye the unko proof kis tarah karte hain. So we are going to consider some few examples in which I am going to explain you how to evaluate the limits. So first of all, limit x approaches to infinity. So this is the example where I am going to calculate infinite limit at infinity. Infinite limits may be aa jaye, may be na aaye, lekin limit at infinity. Agar aap is example ko solve karna chahe, x approaches to infinity, to hamare paas kya aata hai? Infinity minus infinity plus 1, infinity plus infinity minus 1. Infinity plus infinity, we don't have any problem with this one. Lekin infinity minus infinity, ye to undetermined form hoti hai. Infinity over infinity, agar aa bhi jaye, isko define bhi kar diya jaye, infinity minus infinity jo ke define nahi kiya jata mathematics mein, to phir bhi hamare paas undetermined form aati hai. So how to avoid such type of conditions, isko bada easily hum avoid kar sakte hain. Aap dekhen upar bhi jo aapka polynomial hai, it is of degree 2. Denominator mein jo polynomial hai, it is of degree 2. So I can take x square common from both sides, numerator se bhi aur denominator se bhi. 1 over x plus 1 over x square jo hai ye mera ban jayega. Niche se x square se cancel ho jayega. 3 plus 2 over x minus 1 by x ye mera ban jayega. Ab ye jo maine small trick kiya, ab main limit x approaches to infinity jo hai isko main discuss kar sakta hu. 1 over infinity aapko pata hai 0 hota hai. 1 over infinity square ye bhi 0 hoga. So I will left with 2 by 3. So limit x approaches to infinity for that function jisko main f of x keh raha hu, iska kya answer aayega? 2 by 3 answer aayega iski limit. So kuch tricks jo aapne calculus mein kiye hue hain usko main just recall karwa raha hu. Ab find the limit x approaches to 1. Ab agar 1 main substitute kar dun jo aapne calculus mein, the first trick for the evaluation of the limits is ki aap jis point ko approach kar rahe hain wo point put kar dein. 1 minus 1 1 minus 1, ye kya ban jayega? 0 by 0 form, which is once again illegal in mathematics. So we have to do something. Ab yahan pe aapko nazar aa raha hai ki x 8 minus 1 jo hai, isko main likh sakta hu x 4 square minus 1 ka square 1 nahi hota hai. So I know that a square minus b square a plus b into a minus b hota hai. So that will factorize this one, x 4 minus 1 x 4 plus 1. Ye factorization is ki hogi x 8 minus 1 ki. So meri limit jo thi, x approaches to 1, x 8 minus 1 over x 4 minus 1, it reduces to x 4 plus 1. Ab limit is function ki limit jo hai, wo to main easily nikal sakta hu. Even you can find out that limit by using epsilon and delta, lekin main epsilon and delta wala use nahi karunga. So 1 plus 1 equals 2. So limit of that function equals 2. Jo ke agar main point as it is put kar dun, to illegal jo hai wo expression mathematics mein jo hai 0 by 0 form, which is illegal in mathematics, wo hamare paas banti hai. So I suggest you that you open your books of calculus jo ke aapne courses definitely padhe honge, and try to evaluate some limits at infinity. वो भी आप कुछ एग्जांपल्स करें, और लिमिट्स एट फाइनाइट नंबर इन्फिनिटी जा रही हो, इन्फिनिट लिमिट्स में उनकी एग्जांपल्स भी कुछ करें. और फर्दर मोर, क्योंकि वन स्टेप अहेड ये कोर्स है, तो आपको यू शुड ट्राई सम एग्जांपल बाय योरसेल्फ इन विच यू इवेल्युएट बाय यूजिंग एप्सिलॉन एंड डेल्टा. बाय यूजिंग दैट डेफिनेशन यू शुड इवेल्युएट सर्टन limits. Limits ko verify karein by using epsilon and delta.